5
I command them to the abyss.
I command them to the abyss.
Say, God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
You are wonderful.
You are wonderful.
You are glorious.
You are glorious.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
I worship you.
I worship you.
So Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are my Lord.
You are my Lord.
You are my Savior.
You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
Bless me today.
Bless me today.
So Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are the Alpha.
You are the Alpha.
The Omega.
The Omega.
The King of Kings.
The King of Kings.
The Lords of Lords.
The Lord of Lords.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Counselor.
Counselor.
Mighty God.
Mighty God.
Everlasting Father.
Everlasting Father.
I worship you.
I worship you.
Say, wonderful Holy Ghost.
Wonderful Holy Ghost.
I surrender to you.
I
open my heart.
I open my heart.
I open my spirit.
I open my spirit.
Teach me your word.
Teach me your word.
Reveal to me.
Reveal to me.
Your divine revelations. Bless me tonight.
Bless me tonight.
In the name of Jesus. Bible says that where two or three comes together in my name, Jesus said that there I am in their midst. And also tonight, Jesus Christ is here, the Holy Ghost is here, God Almighty is here. We'll have a privilege to sing unto God tonight. Let us get ready to sing unto God tonight.
Oh,
of testimony tonight.
Amen. Our testimony is as follows. Lump on the breast disappear. There is a lady who called for prayer. She has been having a lump that comes and goes since 2015. And also looking for a job. Pastor Robert prayed for her over the phone and she felt heat all over her body. The demon in her started to manifest, saying that it doesn't want her to work because her family will be in a much better state and would think they are better than the demon. That is why her job is blocked. The demon also confessed about putting something on the breast and also made her eyes not to see clearly because she has a sharp vision. She was also blocked from participating on the midnight prayers on Pastor Robert's worldwide WhatsApp group. And the demon also blocked her marriage because her partner was serious with her and wanted to marry her. The demon also confessed that they don't want to see Pastor Robert's phone numbers because they burn his eyes. Pastor Robert casted out the demon out of her life. When she checked the lamp, it was gone and pain-free. Glory to God in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Our announcements are as follows. Every morning at 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, we have our morning prayer, which is at 7 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Our midday service starts at 5 to 12, and then we have our evening service, which starts at 6 p.m. every night. Our midnight prayer starts at 5 to 12 every night, and we also have our weekly prayer and fasting, which is on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. The details of the fasting are shared on our different WhatsApp groups. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight, we'll read the Word of God from the book of Romans, chapter 8, from verse 26, NIV. It reads as follows. In the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we are to pray for, but the Spirit himself intercedes for us through wordless groans. And he who searches our hearts knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance with the will of God. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. Those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say in response to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Amen.
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 Also tonight, you will have a privilege to go through the Word of God together, believing the Word of God to be taught with power. Power of the Holy Spirit, power to heal, power to bless, power to protect in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us go through the Word of God from the book of Romans chapter 8, verse number 26. The Bible says that in the same way the Spirit helps us in our weakness, we do not know what you ought to pray for, but God himself, Spirit himself intercedes for us through the wordless groan. Then the Bible says that the Holy Ghost, because the Holy Ghost, the Spirit, help us in our weakness.
Amen.
What I want us to remember is that when Jesus Christ was promising us, was promising his disciples, Jesus said that, I will not leave you as orphan, but I will ask the Father and he will give you Alles Paracletos, someone who is exactly like me.
Amen.
And this Alles Paracletos is going to be someone who's going to be coming to assist you, to help you, because there is a limitation. A human being by themselves, they've got a limitation. A human being, even though sometimes when you're born again, you have got a limitation. There are certain spiritual reality and certain spiritual truth, certain spiritual activities that you can't be able to do by your own self. Then in order to operate in the spiritual realm, to operate, to participate in the spiritual dimension, to fully fellowship with God in the spiritual realities and the spiritual dimension, we need a divine help of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And that's what He comes to do.
Amen.
To be our helper.
Amen.
To help us in the spiritual activities.
Amen.
To help us in our own weaknesses.
Amen.
In such a way that as a human being, even though, for example, which already is given in the word today that you have just read, where the Bible says that the Holy Ghost help us in our weakness. When He help us in our weakness, for example, you find yourself that you are praying. You want to pray, and this time you are participating in prayer. But as you are participating in prayer, you find that you have got a limitation. You are praying, but you don't know what you are supposed to pray for. You don't know what is it that God wants you to pray for today. You know, sometimes you can have a prayer point, and that prayer point, it is your prayer point, and there are other important things that you are supposed to pray for. And those important things that we are supposed to pray for, they didn't come yet to your mind. Then you see, in that kind of instance, you end up praying amiss. You end up not knowing, you know, not praying for what you are supposed to pray for.
Amen.
And the Bible says that the Holy Ghost, the Spirit help us in our weakness. He comes and fills in the gap. Because one thing that we have to understand about the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, is that we have got God the Father, we have got God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. When you're talking about God the Holy Ghost, He's a third person of a Godhead. As a third person of a Godhead, you know, He knows the spiritual realm. And when you are praying, He knows what is important that you are supposed to pray for.
Amen.
When you are praying, or when you're in a place, as a human being, as you have got a weakness, maybe the only thing that you are able to see is based on what your eyes can see. You are in a place you can see only the things that your human eye can see. But you can't see in the spirit. You can't see what is happening in the spiritual realm. You can see sometimes, you know, you don't know what the witches are planning against you. You don't know what the devil is planning against you. As a human being, sometimes you can't see tomorrow. Tomorrow, maybe the enemy have planned. And as per the what is happening in the spiritual dimension, happening now in the spiritual dimension, planned to happen tomorrow in the spiritual dimension, then you as a child of God, you are praying for certain things that you think that are important. Whereas they're not important, because they are planning against you in the spiritual dimension to finish your life. Then you see, then the Holy Ghost is able to see what is happening spiritually.
Amen.
Whether where you are, the demons. Maybe where you, the following day, there's a certain plan that the enemy have planned against you, that you are not aware, but he's aware. Because he's God.
Amen.
He knows where your enemies are.
Amen.
He can hear your enemies speaking.
Amen.
He can hear your enemies planning against you.
Amen.
Then you see, then now in your prayer, when you are praying, the Bible says that he is able to help us. Hey? To intercede for us.
Amen.
With the wordless groan.
Amen.
You know, it's one thing that you need to understand about the person of the Holy Ghost. The Bible talks about the day that the Holy Ghost came. The Bible says that when Jesus Christ, after his death and his resurrection, then just before he went to heaven, the Bible says that he told his disciples, and he said that you will receive the power when the Holy Ghost comes upon you. In the book of Acts chapter 1 verse number 8, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and until the ends of the earth.
Amen.
And the Bible says that then, as the disciples of Jesus Christ was waiting for the promise that Jesus Christ have given them in the upper room, and they were praying, waiting for the Holy Ghost to come, the Bible says that that day, the Holy Ghost came like a mighty violent wind and filled the upper room. And filled the upper room. And the Bible said that those who were in the upper room, they begin to speak in another tongues. They begin to pray in another tongues. They begin to pray. As they were praying, the Bible said that those who were in the upper room, they were speaking a language that they don't understand. And the Bible said that at the same day, it was the day of the Pentecost, of the festival of the Pentecost. And the Bible said that that day, the Jews from all over the world have come. That means these are the Jews who are speaking different kind of languages. Different kind of languages from all over the world. Then the Bible said that as they were down there enjoying the festival, they begin to hear a loud noise on top of the roof. But now what was different, as they were hearing those loud noise, the loud noise, they would begin to hear that those who were in the upper room were praying.
Amen.
Worshiping God, glorifying God.
Amen.
In different kind of languages.
Amen.
Languages that they were even perplexed, they were even surprised.
Amen.
They're surprised. When they're surprised, they're going like, you know, these are the men from Galilee. How is it that I'm from Asia but I can hear? How is it that someone's coming from Africa but can hear them in their own language? How do they know these languages?
Amen.
That day, it was the day that the Holy Ghost came. As he came, he gave them, you know, ability to pray in another tongues, to speak the languages that they don't understand.
Amen.
And as they were speaking on these languages that they don't understand, the people on the ground there, the Jews from all over the world, could understand them clearly. Oh, that they speak in their own languages. These people are glorifying God. It was the Holy Spirit enabling them to speak in their own languages.
Amen.
Enabling them to pray.
Amen.
Enabling them to pray.
Amen.
Helping them to pray.
Amen.
overcoming their weakness.
Amen.
Overcoming their weakness in such a way that they were telling God what he want to hear at that particular moment.
Amen.
They were not praying amiss. Child of God, one of the things that we need to do in our prayer lives is to depend on the Holy Ghost. Depend on the Holy Spirit to help you to pray.
Amen.
To help you to pray, to help you communicate with God.
Amen.
So that you cannot pray amiss.
Amen.
Otherwise, many people, they pray amiss. They miss, you know, they miss what they're supposed to say. The Holy Spirit is your helper.
Amen.
He's our helper. And one thing that we need to do for ourselves is to depend upon him.
Amen.
In a daily basis.
Amen.
In a daily basis. Even to pray in a daily basis. Pray in spirit.
Amen.
Pray in spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Pray in spirit.
Amen.
Allow the Holy Ghost to be your helper.
Amen.
Allow the Holy Spirit to take over.
Amen.
And he will make our, he is here to make our life easy.
Amen.
He is here to give us a supernatural advantage.
Amen.
So that you can be spiritual.
Amen.
You can be spiritual.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And give us and give you supernatural abilities.
Amen.
That an ordinary person does not have.
Amen.
Supernatural abilities that an ordinary person cannot have. Certain access that others do not have.
Amen.
Where you go like Shakrando Brahakida Sofrahakida Sakia Dolobosh. On that time it becomes a wordless growth.
Amen.
But the Holy Ghost, he knows exactly what to touch.
Amen.
Apostle Paul said that I thank God that I pray in spirit more than all of you. I pray in tongues more than all of you. Then one of the things that we must do is to depend on the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Even to read the Bible, depend on the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Even to pray, depend on the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He is your helper.
Amen.
He is the one who makes you supernatural.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And allow him to take over you. Allow him to do that, because that's what he's here to do.
Amen.
Because you see, one of the weaknesses has already been written there. We do not know what we ought to pray for. Don't know how, what you're supposed to pray for. Then that means if you don't pray in spirit, you are limiting yourself.
Amen.
You are limiting yourself.
Amen.
Then you must make up your mind.
Amen.
That I will pray in spirit.
Amen.
I will pray in spirit. And you pray in spirit.
Amen.
Then the Bible says that in the book of Romans chapter 8, verse number 27. He who searches our hearts knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance to God's will.
Amen.
Then the Bible says that he who searches our heart, God who searches our heart, the Bible says that he knows the mind of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
God is able to communicate with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And if you have to do or even pray having a perfect prayer is the one that you're gonna, you will be practicing when you are praying in the Spirit.
Amen.
When you're praying in the Spirit. You know, Sam, when you're talking about praying in the Spirit, they've got a problem, because when they are praying in the Spirit, they don't know, they don't understand what they're saying. Then they want to understand what they're saying. When they understand what they're saying, they think they're praying effectively. They think they're praying effectively. But in prayer, you're communicating with God.
Amen.
As you're communicating with God, the Bible says that the Word of God is trying to teach us that one of the most important way to pray, it is to pray a spiritually led prayer.
Amen.
A prayer that you don't understand.
Amen.
A prayer that is spiritually led.
Amen.
You know, Apostle Paul says that in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse number 14. For if I pray in tongue, my spirit prays, but my mind is unfruitful. So that if he prays in the Spirit, he doesn't understand what he's praying. He said that when he's praying like that, his mind is, he does not understand what he's praying, because he's not praying with his mind.
Amen.
He's not praying with his understanding.
Amen.
He's praying with his Spirit.
Amen.
On salvation, the day that you're born again, what have happened is that the blood of Jesus Christ washed away our sins. After washing away our sins, one of the things that happened for you to become the child of God, the Spirit of God and our spirit were joined together, and the Holy Ghost quickened your dead spirit and become alive.
Amen.
And you can no longer separate your spirit and the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Your spirit and the Spirit of God is one.
Amen.
Then that's why now, when you are, the Bible is talking about, you have to be able to pray with your spirit.
Amen.
And that is not going to happen when you're trying to pray the prayer that you understand. It's going to happen when you are surrendering yourself unto the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And you allow him to pray through you.
Amen.
And when you're praying, he's praying through you. Sometimes you don't even understand, most of the time, or 100%, you are not going to understand what you're saying.
Amen.
You will only understand what you're saying by the gift again, which is called the gift of interpretation of tongues.
Amen.
And also the one who gives that gift is the Holy Ghost. It's the same thing when you talk about the gift of healing. The gift of healing is also another gift that the Holy Ghost gives.
Amen.
Then when we pray by that gift, God uses it to heal miraculously.
Amen.
But ordinarily, as a human being, you don't have that gift. You have it by the enablement of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
we talk about the 12 gift of the Holy Ghost. Then those are the supernatural abilities that he gives to man. We have got the Holy Spirit of God.
Amen.
They are not just given to anybody.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
Fire, yeah, 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 yeah.
I love the word of God.
I love the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
I'm enjoying the word of God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then the Holy Ghost, when you rely upon him, rely upon him to pray.
Amen.
He will help you to walk with God in his will.
Amen.
To walk with God, to pray in Amen. Accordance to his will.
Amen.
And that's why you need to depend upon him. A Christian walk must be God dependent. The Holy Ghost depended.
Amen.
You need to depend upon the Holy Ghost. He's the best, one of the best gifts that God has ever given to man. We need to depend upon him. Say, oh wonderful Holy Ghost.
Oh wonderful Holy Ghost.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
I surrender to you.
I surrender to you.
Take over me.
Take over me.
Help me to pray.
Help me to pray.
Help me to fellowship with God.
Help me to fellowship with God.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Begin to pray. Begin to pray. Begin to pray. Arakashike telebasondo lobosi andaraba. Arakashike telebi. Katalabashia Karabaye Keterebe Mandarabashia Naraba Arakashe Kerebebebebebe Arakaye Terebe Yandaraba Sundurubu Arakashe Kerebe Keterebe Yakatalabashia Naraba Mandarabasundurubu Yantalabasundalabayateria Mantalabasuturubu Mantarakashekerebe yeketerebebebe Mandarabasundurubu shiakarabayate Akarabayaturuko shiakerebe Yandarabaye Keria Arakashia Karabaso Torobo Mantalabasia Dalaba Mantarabasia Dalaba Arakashia Keribi Mantarakashia Karabababa Mantarakashia Keribi Arakaye terebesi ya katorobo ya karabashiye kerebe Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Fire, 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 fire. I command them to the abyss.
I command them to the abyss.
Anything which is not of God.
Anything which is not of God.
In my life.
In my life.
In my body.
In my body.
In my career.
In my career.
In every sector of my life.
In every sector of my life.
Catch fire now.
Catch fire now.
Catch fire now.
Catch fire now.
I command them.
I command them.
Come out.
Come out.
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 Say, I command.
I command.
Everything to turn around for my good.
Everything to turn around for my good.
Everything.
Everything.
Turn around.
Turn around.
For my good.
For my good.
So let there be progress.
Let there be progress.
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 So let there be miracle jobs.
Let there be miracle jobs.
Say all is well.
All is well.
In my life.
In my life.
In every sector of my life.
In every sector of my life.
Say Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are my Lord.
You are my
Savior.
You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
Bless me today.
Bless me today.
Protect me from today.
Protect me from today.
With your power.
With your power.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Of the Holy Spirit.
So may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus.
The love of God.
The love of God.
The fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
The fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
Be with us all.
Be with us all.
Surely goodness and love.
Surely goodness and love.
Shall follow me.
Shall follow me.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
And I dwell in the house of the Lord forever. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
And I want to say to us tonight, may God bless you. Have a blessed and a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Bye bye, everybody. Have a blessed morning, day, and afternoon and night.
Amen. Bye bye.